What's up, everybody? This is your boy Prime. Thanks for dropping in for this segment of The Matrix. Well, right now I got upon some new stuff that I have got with the Elite. Hopefully y'all are the first ones to see it up here on The Matrix, if y'all basically seeing it. Right here, that's up in front of you right now. These are NBA Live 10 picture shots that I took, and it was a game that I did. And I, you know, any games that I do, I do photo shots, so I keep a lot of photos and everything. So I hope y'all enjoy these. The NBA Elite player models, I really don't care for them too much. Live 10's models were way far more superior, and basically this is what the people wanted. So when y'all check out the player models in Elite 11, y'all can see the transition from 10 to 11, and this is what the people wanted, and this is the reason why I'm gonna start doing photo shoots. But I want y'all to check out this video, y'all. Listen, observe, pay attention, put your comments down. If you're new, subscribe, and go from there. All right, y'all, it's Prime. I'm Ghost One.
In the NBA, in any sport, it's all about matchups.
Matchups is definitely a big thing and probably one of the most important keys to the game.
Matchup objectives come in three stages. At the beginning of your career, it's all about outperforming the guy in front of you. The better he is, the more of a reward you'll get for outperforming him.
You know, regardless of, you know, the attributes that he may have, you gotta use your attributes to your ability or to your advantage.
As you grow and develop, you reach the second stage of the matchup objectives. The expectations are a little higher of you now in your second or third year.
When I first came in, you know, I wasn't worried about the key matchups or anything. Now, you know, in my 10th year and going into the league, you know, the kind of defenses are kind of, you know, focused more on me.
If you lose a matchup to a player with a lower overall rating than you, it's going to cost you. And we feel that's reflective of the expectations that your teammates and your coaches have of you when going up against players who aren't as skilled.
This guy's coming out to kick your butt every night, and you know he's willing to do it.
To complete the matchup objective at its highest stage, you have to not only outperform the other team's best player, but you also have to win the game. Truly great players in the NBA are the face of their franchise. They're the guys that are in the storyline every night, regardless of position.
To be the high scorer, you know, high in assists, high in rebounds, high in blocks, you have to dominate some area of the game.
They might not be necessarily matched up against each other, but people are going to be comparing them against each other in the box scores.
It's always going to be a marquee matchup. You may be the center, you may be the guard, but a lot of times how those two guys play is going to influence the outcome.
At the end of the day, being a legend is winning. You know, it's a lot of guys who's going to be great and is going to be legendary in this game. But to really go down in the books as a legend, you have to win. And you have to win on the biggest stage.
Boom shakalaka!